So back to this, man. Part of the interruption, but I just was compelled to respond to that by my intellectual faculty. Forgive me. Often I have to take little asides and deal with aphasia because I understand that there's a high percentage of people that come to these calls that had lobotomies. So when you provide an application with a name, address, and social security number to sign up for utilities on the property, the social security is the trust account that is prepaid. To access that, you need to be a secure creditor. So you sign up for utilities with a prepaid account. Within 30 days, instead of giving them a bill of exchange on the prepaid account, you keep coming in with liability notes to keep showing a debtor entrance rather than a prepaid entrance on the account because you failed to register. You understand? You failed to become a secure creditor. The application for the utilities is equivalent to signing a negotiable instrument or a private note because your unrestricted signature with the account name and number is equivalent authority for utilities to keep drawing off your prepaid account to run their corporate utility business. You feel me? You understand? So you show a continuing monthly entrance by your bill paying with liability notes, also known as Federal Reserve notes, right? So if you try to pay with a bill of exchange, you should register the original contract you signed because that is equivalent of the unlimited credit access to your prepaid account. That is your asset in the transaction. If it's not registered, you can't show the public, should settle the public side of the accounting. If you send them a bill of exchange that is unregistered like Monza does, they will not accept it. You go back and forth. He tells you something is wrong with your bill of exchange, but it's not. They're not accepting it because it's unregistered and you're not a secured creditor. And he's telling you you don't have to be a secured creditor like so many others out there doing consumer credit. So everything you're doing is unregistered. Why? Because you're not secured creditors. You got to burn the midnight oil, man, and learn this stuff. Do you understand? They cannot see the public side to your bill of exchange. See, they don't get it. The only people I ever heard talking about public and private is Khan Taza Doc and that guy, Yusef L., my brother. Shout out to Yusef L. You go back, Taza Doc's been talking about this since 2009, man, public and private, creating a distinction. See, one of the clients Taza Doc has been dealing with, he told Taza Doc, hey, I haven't been making monthly payments for 30 payments now, 30 months. Do I still have a chance? Taza Doc showed him how to put the three criminal cases on a UCC filing. See, the bill of exchange that you gave them in the criminal case is collateral. The case is not an asset. The case is a form to settle the transaction. The note should be put on the UCC. The criminal case is not settled because you've not made a claim. A debtor can't make a claim, man. You can make a complaint. You can't make a claim. Only a man can make a claim, and a U.S. citizen is not a man. To get back into the status of a man, you have to become a secured creditor. What are you waiting for? I know this sounds foreign to a lot of people. I know it does. You have not put the note as a collateral on the UCC. Now I'm giving you the game, man. Let's get some donations in the room. Let me drop the donation link again, man. my phone should be blowing up, or you should be donating in the super chat. Once again, become a secure creditor now. You want to be able to do any of this? Stop. I know that dude's name, Jonah Bay, man. Stop listening to this dude. This dude told you the secure creditor stuff was garbage because he didn't understand it. He said there's no such thing as a secure party creditor because he doesn't go back in the history and understand that people simply start using the term secure party creditor because you're securing your party. So the proper term is a secured creditor, but you're literally securing your party. That's it. Get it? Once again, this is the KT in the Morning Show, where the truth is sold and bullshit runs a marathon. If you don't want the truth, then don't listen to me. It's the foul mouth Cajon, man. If I offended you, I meant to. This ain't no pity party over here, man. Get up off the pity party. Register now for the up-and-coming seminar, which is going to take place in Cleveland, Ohio. Nefertali's neck. I'm in your neck, Nefertali. Tell your family to come down and get some remedy. Remedy at last. The Ruach HaKadosh is coming to your town through the spirit of the Ruach HaKadosh. Most High willing, Cajon tells the doc will be dead. So you're like a person. Oh, you're dealing with criminal cases? Let me tell you something, my King Benjamin. What? King Benjamin, watch this. King Benjamin and everybody else that's dealing with criminal cases, you're like a person in a mortgage foreclosure. What? You're like a person in a mortgage foreclosure case that stops making payments and has not shown a continual entrance in the property by filing it in the public. See, monthly payments would have actually been a monthly filing of a notice of entrance. A notice of entrance will expire if you don't renew it. You understand? The banks is foreclosing on you, on your corpus, just like a home. You understand? That's why you get 30 years. Well, when you take someone out, you get 30 years just like a mortgage, 25 to life, just like a mortgage, man. You understand? So the bank is foreclosing on your presumed abandonment of your property. What is your property? Your corpus. Dealing with foreclosure is the house. You didn't record your asset, which is your mortgage note that you gave them to begin with. The mortgage note is an asset to your liability to the bank, and you didn't record the note. It's your fault. No one taught you this. Shout out to Patrice, man. Patrice is in the building, man. Bronx, New York. Shout out to Patrice, man. Patrice is in the building, man. Anybody understand what I'm saying? No, you don't, man. That's why you got to listen to this 10 times. And what you really need to do is show up at the seminar in Cleveland, Ohio. Listen, man, if you're in Pittsburgh, you're only 2 hours and 9 minutes away. No reason you shouldn't come. You're in New York, you're not that far away. You're in Chicago, that's why I picked Cleveland, man. It's in that every year. Detroit, all of y'all could get there. No excuses, man. What's going to happen is I'm going to run out of seats, so you better register now. So you didn't record the asset, which is your mortgage note that you gave them to begin with. The mortgage note is an asset to you and a liability to the bank, and you didn't record the note to make it a security registered in the public, so it doesn't show in the public side. Therefore, it is not cognizable by the public court system to give you a remedy when the bank did not close the full accounting with you at escrow closing when you bought the property. And when the note was closed off, the books, the bank's books, that is, right? On their liability side. So you don't have a public claim. And you can never have a public claim as a debtor. You have to be a secured creditor. So how can you claim the note as an asset when you gave it to him? The note is an asset. Just like a lawnmower. Well, if you give it to somebody, they owe you something back. You are the creditor in the transaction.